Sunday is Mother's Day. Yes, that's right before the elections. And so we're going to have a little bit of that chat before the heated elections come around. We'll be talking about Mother's Day as we have a nonprofit organization that provides the love and care of a mother to abandoned and neglected children. It's called SOS Children's Village. So here to talk about this is Leanne Sandoval, the Fund Development Coordinator and one of the NGO's mamas, or Mother Jinky Adona. Good morning and welcome, Ams. Hello.
Oh, hi, Paul.
Well, Mama Jinky, happy advance Mother's Day to you. And of course, you know, this is a very special day that we know of. We give our love to our traditional moms, yeah. But you know, in many, many ways, different moms come in different varieties, correct? Yes. Let's talk about SOS first before we get to hear about Mama Jinky's story. All right. I've gotten a chance to visit SOS.
Yes.
It's beautiful inside. You guys currently have how many children's villages in the Philippines?
So in the Philippines, we have 8 villages. So we have in Bataan, Iloilo, Cebu, Manila, Calbayog, Davao, Tacloban, and the oldest of them all, where we are based, mm-hmm. in Lipa.
Mm-hmm.
So we just celebrated our 49th anniversary just last May 1.
Oh, yes, look at fresh. That. Happy 49th birthday to SOS. SOS is actually from Europe, correct?
Yeah. IMS Austria, yeah.
Oh, from Austria, that's right. And so even when you go and visit the villages, you can see kind of the influence of the homes. Mm-hmm. The homes are brick homes. The way that the village is kind of set up, it may be different from other children's villages.
Yeah.
And how many children have been a part of SOS in some way?
For in Lipa, we have a total of 143 children and youths, mm-hmm. being supported by SOS. But in the whole Philippines, we have a total of 1,071 children.
Wow.
All over the Philippines.
Mm-hmm. Affecting so many lives,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, exactly.
And personally, personally affecting the lives of children, Mama Jinky. How many years have you been an SOS mom?
As an SOS mom, I've been 18 years.
18 years yes. na? Wow, tagal na. Paano mo naisip na maging SOS mom?
Na ano po ako kasi yung tinawag akong mama ng bata na nasa aking pangangalaga. Oo, doon ako nagkaroon ng ano na maging mama. Sabi ko i-go-go ko ng pagiging mama kasi bago yun, auntie muna kong tawagin.
So sa SOS na po talaga kayo? Were you naging volunteer po ba? Or paano po nag-umpisa yung relationship niyo, yung journey niyo sa SOS?
Bali po nag-apply ako as an SOS aunt. So yun po.
Ano ba yung SOS aunt? So for those who may not be ready to take on the full-fledged, kasi may training pa yata bago ko maging mama. Oo,
SOS aunt po, dito sa stage na to nagkakaroon ng 2 years training na ano sa theoretical at saka practical training. Tinuturoan kami paano mag-handle ng bata sa different stages ng development hanggang sa late ng teenage years nila.
Wow, and it must have been so nice, no, to feel na tinawag ka ng mama. Pakikwento sa amin kung ano yung nangyari noon. Ilang taong ka noon and gano'ng kayo katagal magkasama nung bata before kanya kinilala as kanyang mommy?
Bali po, 23 years old lang po ako noon kasi bagong ano ako sa bahay niya. May 10 bata na doon ako dumating. Tapos nag-prepare kami ng food for dinner. Nandun sila sa table, sama-sama kami. Tapos yun, tinawag niya akong ma. Doon kinilabutan ako kasi first time kong matawag ng mama. Tapos hindi ko pa sila mga biological na anak. So yun.
It really proves, I mean, mother-daughter, mother-son relationships, mm-hmm. can transcend bloodlines kahit hindi kayo magkadugo, di ba? Mm-hmm. Basta na doon yung nafo-foster yung relationship, yeah. Which how does SOS make sure, how do you guys make sure that relationship is nurtured and fostered between the mother and the children?
Well, the mother love the children.
Mm-hmm.
So they, as what Mama Jinky mentioned, so they undergo several trainings, mm-hmm. since they do not have the normal delivery or the actual delivery of having a baby.
Mm-hmm.
So after that, so the different trainings, and after that, the mother inside the house needs to take good care of these children.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, with a full passion towards their child.
And the way that it's really set up is they're houses in the village, a number of houses in the village, mm-hmm. and in one home, mm-hmm. how many children?
About 8 to 10 kids.
8 to 10 children. So, ilan ang anak mo ngayon, Mami Jinky?
Sa ngayon po, sa bahay, mayroon akong 7, tapos nasa youth facility, 2. Yung youth facilities, mga boys yun. Tapos, okay. Mayroon pa akong 4 na nasa boarding house. So, mayroon akong 13 na anak.
13, yeah, no, di ba?
Pero kung anin po, sa lahat-lahat po, mm-hmm. yung naging anak ko na is 28.
Wow, in the past 18 years?
Yes,
18
po.
Years, okay. Naging 28.
May apo na din po siya.
Ilan na yung apo mo?
22 po, sa 9 na anak na iyong.
Ha? So 28 yung naging anak mo, tapos 22?
Yung apo.
Apo? Wow,
sa 9 na yan. Anak.
Sa oh, how nice. Mm-hmm. Ano, so, pa, kahit na nag-graduate na sila sa village, kasi the process is, at a young age, nag-start sila sa village hanggang sa nag-schooling, di ba? Yeah. Hanggang mm-hmm. high school, hanggang
until
college.
Until they graduated from college.
Until
that's
graduate
the time
from college.
That they have to live SOS.
Ah, okay.
And live their own lives.
Okay, okay. Yeah. So, marami na rin ang nakagraduate, ang nakaalis na rin sa,
yes,
sa village.
Po.
Pero, from what I understand also from my prior visit, mm-hmm. they tend to really come back and visit
exactly.
their mothers, just yes, as if, you know, children really go and visit their parents. Mm-hmm. Baka mas mm-hmm. madalas pa nga sila nakakabisita kaysa sa akin. sa magulang ko, gano'ng kakadalas binibisita ng mga anak mo?
Ano, every Sunday, pero every year, mayroon kaming parang reunion ng lahat ng mga naging anak ko every Christmas.
Oh.
Umuwi sila sa bahay, doon kami nagsasama-sama, may get together.
At lalong lumalaki at lumalaki yung
yes,
iyong pamilya.
That's
it. Of course, there are very nice stories when we hear about that, when we hear about raising kids and the success stories. Pero, syempre, sa buhay ng isang ina, marami rin challenges, marami mm-hmm. rin things, lalo na that nahihirapan tayo. Ano yung mga ibang challenges na overcome mo, Mami Jinky?
Bali, yung pinaka-ano ko na challenges is yung pagbagong dating yung bata sa akin kasi kailangan mong turuan proper ano toilet training kasi mm-hmm. sila naman ay galing sa bundok. Yung mga natanggap ko is galing sa iba't ibang lugar, galing bundok. So, yun, training sa kanila, paano sa pag-CR. Mm-hmm. Tapos yung isa pa is pag nagkakasakit talaga yung mga bata. Mm-hmm. Yun yung nararamdaman ng isang nanay na hindi ka makatulog kapag hindi okay yung anak. Yun po.
Well, napakalaki ng puso mo kasi ang daming laman, no? Ang daming lamang mm-hmm. bata. And in 49 years of mm-hmm. SOS Children's Villages in the country, what more are you planning? Are any plans to expand within the country and make sure that more children's lives will be affected or tuloy pa rin yung number of villages natin ngayon?
Well, for the expansion, it will be depend on the funds that we are raising.
Mm-hmm.
So, if the funds that we raise for the 3 consecutive years is high, mm-hmm. then we can put up a village, another village. And I think in the SOS, we are planning to put up in Tarlac.
Oh, great. Yeah. Oh, for some of the Yolanda victims or some of the children or just...
No, for the Yolanda victims, they are in Tacloban.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
They are already in Tacloban.
That was a little memory gap. Oh, you already have in Tacloban. Mm-hmm. In Tarlac, you'll have another
yeah.
one. Okay.
That's and the, I think, that's the thing that we are working out.
Okay, okay. It may be a dream that may be fulfilled in 2000,
yes.
in the next couple of
yeah,
years.
Yes.
Okay.
But for the next year, we will be celebrating our 50th year, so...
It's a big celebration.
Yeah,
yes.
It's a huge celebration.
And for Mother's Day, what are the plans for SOS moms this Mother's Day, Mama Jinky?
For us, may mga get together yung mga mama, tapos nagpla-plan yung office para yung mga bata, binibigyan kami ng flowers, mm-hmm. mga sulat, pero sa bahay talaga, yung mga anak ko is gumagawa sila ng sulat. May mga ganun-ganun na kaya nakaka-touch.
Nakaka-touch talaga. Okay. I know, I can see, nakikita mm-hmm. ko yung ano yung aura nyo po na talagang malamal niyo yung mga anak mo. Ano po yung mensahe nyo with maybe some of our viewers? Some people na baka gusto na lang i-entertain yung thought na maging SOS mommy din or to be part of SOS in one way, shape, or form. Ano pong masasabi niyo sa kanila?
Bali, ano po, ano lang nila na pumunta sa amin, bisitahin kami para makita nila. Kasi once na nandoon na sila sa lugar, makikita nila yung pooling mas lalong na pagtitibay. So, visit sila sa amin sa SOS Lipa.
Doon po kasi nila mapifeel talaga yung talagang family kapag naka-visit na sila sa village.
And I felt that when I visited your Montenupa village, and I want to say a happy 49 years to SOS. We'll look forward to the new village in Tarlac.
but it's temporary.
We'll see. Yes. So hopefully that will be fulfilled there in Tarlac. And Mommy Jinky, happy Mother's Day. And all the very best to SOS, lalo na. Thank you for sharing your story with us. It shows na talagang the motherhood has no bounds, right? The love of a mother has no bounds. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.